Hi. In some respects, I should probably be putting this at Equals Project, but I don't want to kind of sidetrack that or make that a place for this kind of conversation, really. As many of you will know, I recently set up a project there called God for a Day and got some lovely questions, in the sense that they're the sort of questions, you know, from you, that they're all the sort of questions that we can't really answer, that we would love to have answers to. They're kind of human questions that are kind of imponderables, but of course we ponder on them, and some of us think that we have the correct answers, which we may or may not do. But and thank you very much for those of you who were enthusiastic, for your enthusiasm. But it's very interesting, the sort of the responses that have come thus far. I know there are more to come. I'm pretty sure there are more to come anyway. So this is a kind of an interim thing. But it is notable by the absence of any Christian responses, bar one of a very old friend of mine who is not the run-of-the-mill Christian anyway, but is always willing to try and make a change for the better in the world. And in that, we have a lot in common, even though our ideas are different. You know, in my opinion, he is what a Christian should look like, in the sense that he's very open to engaging with people in order to communicate. The other responses said so far, you know, there may be more to come, have been once from been from a Hindu, once from been from a pantheist, and once from me, of course, and once from someone I can't possibly begin to describe exactly what it is that you believe, but nonetheless, you know, you have belief in a God, but not the traditional kind of Christian belief. And there's only one atheist who said, this is ridiculous, we can't talk about this because it's about an Abrahamic God, which actually it isn't. If anybody actually bothered to read the brief, it was about seeking truth, and that you could answer from any perspective that you liked. You know, these are, as I said, fundamental human questions. So my question is for you Christians, which you probably won't answer, I do appreciate this, but that in itself is bizarre and interesting. Why aren't you responding? You know, here is a perfect opportunity for you to communicate with the people you claim you wish to communicate with, in order to offer some insight and some reasons, some real reasons as to why you follow the faith that you do, and you've not taken it. Now, I did watch a video yesterday by one American Christian who claimed that because a lot of atheists knew the Bible better than the Christians, they were in fact of the devil, because the devil knows the Bible better than Christians. Fabulous get-out clause, really, for engaging in any serious way. So maybe that's why. Maybe you think I'm off the devil. It has been levelled at me before by a bunch of Christians, and the bishop proved them wrong. And they, of course, realised who I actually was further down the line. And I'm not suggesting that they're accusing me of being the devil particularly anyway, but it's very interesting how dismissive a lot of you Christians out there are. There's the odd one, like a cyber guy who's generally very forthcoming, though you seem to be kind of steering away at the moment. I'm not sure whether that's from pressure from your brothers or not. So yes, why aren't you answering? Why don't you want to take the opportunity to change some minds, or to present your case in a really practical, useful way for people. What do you really not want converts? Do you really just want to be a member of your club, which is what it's looking like? Do you really just want to ridicule people who don't see things the same as you do, which Bible thumping wing nut seems to be particularly fond of? It's not very smart, and it's certainly not what you are told to do by your faith. Many of you seem to be doing the antithesis of what it is that you're asked to do. So I'm just curious, you know, please enlighten me. Why haven't you responded? Why do you seek to ridicule? Why do you seek to isolate yourself? Why do you perceive anybody who is in the slightest bit interested in having a conversation with you as the devil incarnate? And so on, you know, please, I would be very grateful for some answers to these questions. Thank you.